break. Damn hard. Nobody else ever.
That's four students from the fifth grade class at Baird Elementary School. I'm going to let them introduce themselves and let them tell you about their project that they're doing with Bob.
Corey Jonet.
Kyle Cropsey.
John Seidel.
And Elvin Steinhoff.
And I'm going to have Eldon tell us why he chose to do something about something with lizards.
We chose to do something about lizards because it sounded like a very fun, interesting thing to research on. And I also had my lizards that would also help the project a lot.
And what did your research tell you? What is the research, the science fair exhibit, going to be all about?
It's going to be...
What did you learn doing the project?
We learned a lot of stuff about the lizards and what their habitat is.
And I think we called it Living with Lizards.
Science and More Science. My friends from Mrs. Klein's fifth grade science class are here to fill us in with the help. Well, Bob didn't quite make it, did he? He slept in, our gecko. All right, well, let's first start with John, and let's talk about lizards. What do we need to know about them?
Well, me and my group researched the common iguana, and most of them can climb trees. The black iguana, and that's cold-blooded. We researched horned lizards, and it has more than 12 different kinds of horns. And we also researched geckos, and they're the smartest lizards in the world.
All right. Well, Kyle, I think the next question that comes to mind is I got to ask you, well, how did this expo go over the weekend?
The expo went well, and it was really interesting to see other people do their projects, and there's really neat and interesting stuff, and you got to learn about what other people like.
I know Tom Mahoney's big into this, and he tells us, you know, all kinds of great stuff, especially working with all you guys. All right, Corey, got a question for you. Some more facts on lizards.
Well, lizards are cold-blooded, and without sunlight and heat, they would not survive inside the wild. There are more than just these four, but these are just our favorites, so we picked them out of the hundreds.
Out of the hundreds, wow. All right, I'm going to have you pass the microphone. And Eldon, now, I know that Bob was, you know, going to come in, but he's sleeping in. So I got to ask you, just in general, about, geckos. They're cute, but do they make good pets?
Well, Bob is different than all other pets. He's not like a cat and dog.
Mm-hmm.
You have to give him a lot of heat and sunlight. You have to turn on his light on and off. He eats live crickets, which can sometimes be a pain to bring back to the pet store.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just different because he's not furry.
Right.
He's not whatever.
Yeah, he's really different. So,
yeah.
You know, when you think about, oh, I want to get this kind of a pet, you need to really think twice, don't you?
Yeah, it took me a long time to make the decision of getting him.
Yeah, all right. Well, I'm glad you were responsible in that decision-making. All right, guys, thanks a lot for coming in this morning. It's so great to see you. I know it's early in the morning, but now you're all refreshed for your day of school. Thanks a lot. All right.
Thank you.
Well, still to come. She's
the light side!
I have a force.
You have two options.
I found your lighter.
You lay down, or I make you.
I'm like... Go again.
Okay, my turn. And Rob? We got to go outside.
We got to...
Hey,
I gotta get a fish.
Alright. Hey, go straight up. Corey, keep it like that.
My phone's
on it.
All the time! Ah! Oh, you can't!
Oh,
I fell.
Did that hurt?
Yeah,
let me see.